Makes some nice little clowns that just float around and have fun all day.
And it's Tuesday. What is it? December 3rd. Holy crap. Run out of days before Christmas. Not to panic or anything like that, but yeah. Panic. Fun. Anyway, going to just basically get to it. Decided to switch back over to Warhammer because I wanted to paint this guy for some reason. Wanted to paint him, so we're painting him today. We'll see how far we get. Let's just get to it. Damn. Right off the bat, coughing. All right, so I did another paint stream with the Soulmason, and we did his chair, which turned out pretty good. The instant I go live, we start coughing. Anyway, the chair turned out pretty well. Still gonna work on this gem, shading it up and everything. I haven't done the front or the back on it yet, but that will get shaded to look more like a gem rather than just sitting around. So this is the little dude that sits on it. Looks something like that. Or at least on the box art. He just sits in his little chair. Hangs out. So, I'm going to do him in a similar paint scheme to... It's Ivory Host modified a little bit. So, let's just get to it. For the armor, the underplates, which are going to be a absolute bear to get to, we're going to start off with the Thornwood Green, which makes absolutely no sense considering we're bringing it back up to white, but just work with it. It's a process. Work with it. So, there isn't too much of the armor on the chest, because there's these little dangly bits that it's all hiding behind. It's probably one of those parts where it's like, you should have looked at that and probably figured out some way to sub-assembly that. But it didn't work. So, oh well. So like I said, there's not too much of his armor showing. And because those little bits are going to get painted over again here in just a little bit, I'm not too worried about hitting those. I just want that darker bit on the part that we're going to do into the ivory. So back along there. Staring at the top of my head again. There we go. Like I said, we're just gonna... I'm not too worried about it. Splash damage. Whatever you want to call it. But we're going over a little bit. Not a big deal right now. Now, also the upper part of his skeleton pope hat. We'll be coming back over the raised parts of that, but I want it down into the little recess that is there. So it gets washed, right? Or gets painted. Not washed. So we'll just come along through there. Like I said, we're going to be going over those bits right there on the raised part. I just want this in the recesses mainly, so I'm not terribly worried about it. This isn't to be neat and clean section yet. And then the back of the Pope hat. Up along there. Putting this down pretty thin. Because we're going to be going back with some different shades of white pretty soon, right after this. It doesn't have to be perfect. I just want that shade in the recesses. And I sort of want it to influence the color a little bit. A little bit of that color is going to shine through. So, not too bad. That. Not too bad. That's Jacob posted my favorite painter. That's because I paint your stuff. All right. So we're going to go to the Menoth white base. Don't need too much of it because there's not too much to paint. Just a little scoop. Water. Hoping the mic isn't picking my stomach growling up, but it might have. Who knows?
So just a little bit of that color, leaving just like a, almost like a line around the top where we just shaded. Like I said, the little ridges there on his hat, we're going to be going back over those in a bit, so I'm not too worried. Still a little bit on there, but I'm not too worried about getting it all. If it goes over, it goes over. Not a big deal. Through there, I'm just going to leave that line in the center. There's not going to be a whole lot of white showing there, so not a big deal. We're just going to go down here to the bottom. Sort of go right in the middle, down to the bottom of this. Take your time. Get the paint where you want it to go. So, now for the really fun part. Sarcasm. We're going to try to get along the bottom of each one of these and leave just a little bit at the top on these panels. And then down along here, one more little panel. Right there. Because we did that darker color, we'll have to go back and just give a little more, because that darker brown will show through. You know, we're gonna come back with a lighter color on top of that, that's fine. We want a little bit of it come through, but not everything. Bottom. Right there. Right there. Right there. Take your time. Get the brush in there and let it do what it's supposed to do. And then on the back, there's a huge spot. There we go. Go right up along the edge and then back over. Still leaving that pretty light because we want that little darker dark lining sort of left around it. Let me just go down. Dry for a second and then bring back just a little bit more of it and brighten that up toward the bottom. There we go. Just go. Along the back. Let that fill in. No big deal. A little spot along the edge there. There we go. A little bit of water there. We'll come back and give it just a little bit more. Hold on 1 second. There we go. So, basically what we're doing is we're leaving that dark right around the edge, because this is actually going to be painted a different color. And what we've done is we've brought that up, and it's hard to tell with the shading, but or with the white, but this down here is a little bit more solid than this up here, so it sort of blends into that color. I'm going to do one more shot at it. extra run there on the top. Down there along the bottom. Not a problem. So, we're going to grab Manoth White Highlight. Let's give that a good shake. Put a little of that down. Need a little bit more because it's going to actually, because the other colors are darker, it'll take a little bit more to get into that. But it'll be all right. A little bit on the brush. We're gonna go right up here. And down along. Just sort of blend that up into that other bit. Just a little. Nothing too drastic. Let that dry for a minute and we'll come back to it. Take just a little bit of that white, get it good and thinned out. Pull that off the top there. A little bit of that back off there. There we go. Then we're going to take this little bit. We're going to start down here at the bottom. Just work our way up. I'll just sort of blend this right through here. That dry for a second, we'll come back and give it another shot. Just a real thin shot of this along the bottom. those armor plates. Nothing big. Don't forget the other side.
Come back up here
to the top and work on that. Bit along there. Bend that a little bit. Bit along the bottom there.
Then we'll come back around.
Put that white back along the bottom. Bring this up. And just blend that in.
So, starting to get a little bit more of a blend there. And take a couple of runs because we're doing it real thin and real slow. So,
no biggie.
Go. Go back up to the top and hit a little bit more. Alright, so we got the start on that. We may have to go back and touch it just a little bit more to make it pop a little bit, but it's a good start on it. So, we switch over to Mechanicus Standard Gray, wherever it's hiding. Nope, not done soon. It's not over there. Storm Vermin, nope. Darn Sean.
He was hiding over in Iraq.
So we'll take just a little bit of that. Not too much. A little bit goes a long way. And we'll take and do the outer trim here on the armor. So wrap along in there. I'm not too worried about it hitting the top of that. I just don't want it to get into the part we've already done white, so come down underneath that arm right there. Right along the edge. Along the back. So this is one of those reasons I sometimes don't put everything on, because trying to get to that would be next to impossible if he was glued in. Just a little spot right there. The same thing over on this side. Trying to get to that would just be a bear. So the cape comes down. Damn it. My brush is not wanting to cooperate. So what's happening is the bottom of the brush, the tip of the brush, is hitting one spot, and then like the body of the brush is hitting another. And it's trying to bend it in like two different directions, which brushes do not like to do. The second you start doing that stuff, the brush starts wanting to try to separate and do all kinds of weird things. Damn it. There we go. Come on, brush. Along the bottom. picked up.
Where the bottom of the armor wraps back around.
A little bit right there. Right there at that edge. Sort of got that little lip. There we go. Then we're going to take right up here along the top. Give this a little gray coat. Down around there, like so. Just trying to be careful as we get down. I don't want to go back into that white that we've already done. So not a problem. Sure, I got all the little ridges and recesses and the hat there. And then this little section. This should get interesting right here. So the little, there's like a little frill, I guess. I don't know what you want to call it. It's a little frill right here that goes around. I his hat. Just go. Just around the top like that. His hat. Over here, because there's a little skull right there too, which we'll be going back and doing in a metallic, or that's the plan so far. Like so. We're going to give the staff another little shot here. I'm not worried about going in because I want that inner edge to be in the gray. So actually, we're just gonna coat all those. We'll come back. The little skulls I'll probably come back and do in a metallic, but they gotta be mounted into something, so the gray needs to be back behind them too. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Just wrapping around. So we'll end up doing... I like the snake bite leather as far as the contrast paints. It does a great job. So what I will probably do is wait for this all to dry. Touch this up just a little bit. And give that wrap that goes down a treatment in snake bite leather, because it does do so well. So dance around right there. Shot around there. Alright, so what we'll do is we'll give those a wash with some Nuln oil. Whichever oil it is. We'll give those a shot with that. Shake. I don't want too much, but I don't want too little either. I don't want this running all over the place. I certainly don't want it running back into the white shade that we've already done. I do want it to fall in those recesses right through there. So just very carefully doing that around like so. Just put that wash, make sure it doesn't get away. A little bit right through there. Put it right through there. Back here on the gray. Underneath the arm. Back into there. And that's exactly what we didn't want happening. hit that little bit right there. And then just wicked right down. Not a whole lot we can do about it. But try to clean it up real fast. Said we're just trying to get that back there, not let it pull too much. And let him sit back down. So yep, let's go across the bottom of this. And the gray is still wet up here in this, so I do not want to throw that wash into there unless I just want a muddy mess. Bit across on these. Right there. Darken that up just a little bit more. Like so. There we go. Well. Alright. So, I gotta wait for this gray to dry. So. Gotta wait for this gray to dry because I don't know if you can see it on this, but the, like back here around those skulls and everything, it's still wet. If I put the shade in there right now, it's just gonna be a hot mess. So with those dried out, we'll take a little dawnstone and put it across it to do the highlights, and then maybe just a little bit brighter depending on whether or not it needs it. We may go up into like an Altherian gray to pick up the very very tips, and then we'll be doing like the we'll doing something similar to this for the bone on him, like his arms and his legs, and that'll start off, I think, in Screaming Skull, and then we work our way back up towards just an off-white, and but that's where we're at right now, so we're going to stop here because it's a good stopping point. The cloak and everything we're going to do in the, sort of like the flaps on this. And so we'll be doing that cloak in a similar paint. And but like I said, we're at a good point to stop. So for today, that's what we're gonna call that one done for now. And we're gonna go back up here. So thanks for tuning in. Not a whole lot done on that Joker, but it's very small,
hard to get in spots, so it takes a little more time to get in there and get those done. It takes a while on some of these guys. There's little details here, little details there that dingle and dangle and just bear to paint. So hang with me. We'll keep working on him, and we'll get him on his throne eventually. So have a good day. Have a good rest of your Tuesday. I won't be doing a live stream tomorrow I won't be doing a stream tomorrow, period. I've got some stuff to do with my mom, so I'll be gone for that, and I'll probably do one later on Thursday. Usually do it around noon, but probably not going to be back by then, but I'll probably do one like late Thursday evening or something. But have a good rest of your day wherever you're at. Try to stay warm. I know it's not warm here, but try to stay warm, and go paint something. Thank you.